Hello, Patrick Walchuk here with an update on the multi-unit residential property market in Ottawa for the first 4 months of 2017. We'll break it into two different types of housing categories. The first one is apartment buildings with 2 to 4 units, and the number that have sold so far this year is up 5.8% compared to the first 4 months of last year, and the average price is $675,000, which is an increase of almost 17%. The list to sell price ratio, this is how much sellers are getting compared to their asking price, is a little over 97%. When we look at the larger types of these buildings, that's anything with 5 or more units in them, the number sold is up a whopping 160%. And the average price is a little over $1.2 million, which is down a significant amount of money, 10.5%. But not to be too dramatic about this, we're talking really small numbers. I believe it's like 4 sales last year compared to 13 this year or something like that. So the percentages are wildly fluctuating, but we're talking about a small database right now. For these buildings so far this year, the list to sell price ratio is about 94%. So this month I thought that we would take a look at a larger building that sold, because previously we've looked at the financials on 3 and 4 unit buildings. So there was a sale in the Carlington neighborhood that was an 8 unit building, and I did not see the building, but from what I've read and heard about it, it was actually quite a nice building and it was really, really well taken care of. So this property sold for $1,240,000. The scheduled rental income on it was $98,556. When we deduct 4% for vacancy and bad debt, that gives us an effective rental income, or an ERI, of $94,614. Now, the total operating expenses for this building were $31,000 and change, which gives us a net operating income of $63,508. Knowing that, and knowing what it sold for, the cap rate on that is 5%. And the operating, by the way, 5% is maybe what you would consider a little bit low for a place like Carlington or a Vanier. So I think what this speaks to is the quality of the property. The operating expense ratio is 33%, which is quite good, actually. And this property sold for a multiple of the gross, 13 times the gross. And when we say gross here, by the way, that's the effective rental income up here. And it sold for 20 times the net. Now, if somebody were to buy this property and go in with a 35% down payment, that is $434,000. That's 35% of the selling price, right? So they end up with a mortgage of $806,000. So if they took out a mortgage and they got a 3.3% rate on it and they amortized that over 25 years, what you're looking at is an annual debt service, or how much they pay in a mortgage for a year, of $47,280. So their cash flow is their net operating income minus their mortgage, and what you end up with is a positive cash flow of $16,228, and that represents an ROI, a return on their investment, of 3.7%. Now, your investment is your down payment, in this case here, $434,000, so you're making 3.7% on that, which is considered to be quite good in today's market.